It's coming through a hole in the air from those gnats in Tiananmen Square. It's coming from the field that this
25 before the hour. I'm not going to go back to it. We temporarily lost our internet connection anyway, so... you know, this is supposed to be a State of the Union message, and I'm not sure anymore what a State of the Union message is about. Usually they turn out to be more or less campaign speeches. Old Barack Obama, who is, you know, who would like to do all these things he talks about, and he's up against a Congress that is not going to do anything. So... no offense intended to anybody here, but this is just, it's craziness, you know? It's just pure craziness. So I guess what we're going to do is just leave the State of the Union address. And I will tell you this, Speaker Boehner issued a warning to Obama ahead of tonight's speech. And Boehner, and he says these things without irony. This is the part that cracks me up, you know, for these guys to say this stuff and really mean it. He says, we have a constitution, we abide by it. If he, Obama, tries to ignore it, he's going to run into a brick wall. Oh, yeah. What he's talking about, the concerns that Obama is preparing to bypass Congress this year with a bunch of executive orders. For example, raising the minimum wage for new federal contract workers to $10.10 an hour from the current $7.25 an hour. And Obama will use the move if he goes through with this. I'm still waiting for him to put on those comfortable shoes and get out there and march on the picket line. But anyway, if he does this, it'll apply pressure to Congress to approve a similar increase for workers who are not federal workers. But I think you and I can pretty much agree that this is not going to happen. Do you think? Boehner reminded Obama not to overstep his bounds as he weighs other executive actions. Boehner said, quote, House Republicans will continue to look closely at whether the president is faithfully executing the laws as he took an oath to do. Now, I think dealing with federal contracts and minimum wage, he probably has the authority to do that. But we're going to watch very closely because there's a constitution that we all take an oath to, including him. Yeah. I mean, this is just crazy talk, isn't it? To watch the theater that the State of the Union is. I'm looking at the screen right now. Joe Biden is sitting there winking at somebody. Now, he's not just blinking his eyes. He's winking at somebody. Boehner, I don't think Boehner has ever looked any way other than comatose. He said today, I think, somebody quoted him saying that the most difficult night of the year for him is to sit behind Obama and listen to the State of the Union address. Well, the way he handles that, he just gets drunk on his ass before he takes his place. And I guess it's sitting behind an African-American president that just disturbs Boehner. On the other hand, when you really look at the two of them, you'll notice that Boehner is darker skinned than Obama. Look. I don't know. Some Democrats are warning Obama to tread carefully, too. James Carville, the raging Cajun, Mary Matlin's husband. Carville said, I wish I could do Carville. I've never been able to do Carville. He's just so goddamn insane. He really is. I mean, James Carville is just mad. But he says, we hope he does not dwell on... No, I say I can't do it. We hope he does not dwell on the successes of the economy, which may be apparent in employment statistics, the GDP and stock market gains, but which are not felt by folks at the grocery store. That's very true. So that's the thing. When you know, the first part of that that we were listening to, it sounds, it sounds like something that we wish, I wish, were true. Because if what Obama's talking about really was in play, or really was operating, really working, I think I could probably back off a little bit from this idea that there's got to be a peaceful social revolution in this country to change the way we operate here. So when I listen to Obama now on these State of the Union addresses, I can't help but think, you know, this is theater. It has no meaning whatsoever. It's wishful thinking. I guess I don't know. Anyway, according to a preview of his speech, the president will present Congress, it says here, with an agenda largely unchanged from what he called for a year ago. You see, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, Obama can get up there every year, which he has. Remember, he used to talk about reaching across the aisle when he talked about wanting to work with the Republican leadership. Remember all that crap? Huh? Remember where that went? Huh? How's that working out? Right? So it's been a year since the last time he went through this, a year since the State of the Union address that followed the massacre in Connecticut, and nothing's changed, except now Boehner's talking about impeachment. They're trying to end his health care law again. I mean, it's just, what's the point? What's the point for real? You know what I'm saying? What's the point? The real State of the Union for workers? It's pretty cool. This is at Huffington Post. The number of workers living in poverty exploded during the Great Recession and its aftermath as people were hobbled by part-time work, temporary employment, the disproportionate growth of low-wage jobs. You know, when this president or any president talks about job growth, he said 8 million jobs have been created in the past 4 years or whatever he said. Yeah, what kind of jobs, Mr. President? Come on. Come on. Get real. Okay? Just once. Just try. Get real. Most workers have endured at least a decade of wage stagnation, with their pay being well outstripped by corporate profits. What about that? I'm not going to bring the sound back up again, so I don't know if he's going to talk about corporate profits and these CEOs and the productivity of the American worker that has skyrocketed while wages are lower now in real dollars than they were when, in 1968? Now, included in this real State of the Union for workers are a few categories, like warehouse workers. Warehouse workers, like at Amazon.com, maybe. Warehouse work is the hidden engine of the U.S. retail sector, but many of the so-called lumpers. Ever heard that term before? I haven't either. Lumpers. Those are people who load trucks bound for major retailers. They earn poverty wages on a contingent basis. The companies whose products are being moved prefer to outsource the warehouse responsibilities to third parties, which in turn outsource the work to other third parties. That would make them a fourth party, I guess. While it saves the companies plenty of money, the Byzantine contracting arrangements tend to blur the lines of corporate accountability, leading to a widespread allegations of wage theft and other abuses by temp firms at the bottom of the contract chain. That's how this works. As one expert put it to the Huffington Post, quote, all these companies, wherever they possibly can, they want to create a workforce that doesn't work for them, end quote. Dollar store employees, huh? The dollar stores, you know, Dollar General, Dollar Tree, Family Dollar, one of the fastest growing sectors of the retail economy. By one measure, a new dollar store is opening every 6 hours in the United States. That's because nobody can afford Walmart anymore. Fewer and fewer people can afford Target. So now we're working our way down the food chain, dollar stores. What's next? 50-cent stores? Huh? Much of the growth, as Huffington Post reported, is underwritten by dubious labor practices by the big chains that collectively employ over 100,000 people. Even though managers spend their days doing grunt work, like unloading trucks and stocking shelves, Their designation as managers excludes them from basic protections in federal labor law. Newspeak, just change the word, change the meaning. Like a guaranteed minimum wage, time and a half for overtime. Some of these managers work so hard physically, they get hurt. But at the end of the day, they don't earn much more than the workers they oversee. Managers at these dollar stores throughout the country are now suing the chains over these practices. Do you think they're going to win? No, I don't either.